Karamshila Narayana Super Speciality Hospital is one of the oldest cancer hospitals in the country. It was started somewhere in the mid-90s, and the bone marrow transplantation unit is a relatively young department in that sense. It started in 2013. The transplantation scenario in India is vastly different from the West. In the West, we could procure majority of our donors from unrelated donor registry, whereas in India, it was virtually impossible. So we embarked on what we call a half-match or haploidentical family donor program. This program was initiated in 2010 in association with Professor Aversa from Parma, Italy, and Professor O'Donnell was at Seattle at that time.
In the late 90s, I had the good fortune to be part of a team at Johns Hopkins, including Ephraim Fuchs, Leo Luznik, and Rick Jones, that designed the first trial of post-transplant cyclophosphamide, which made possible haploidentical transplants using T-replete bone marrow. Haploidentical transplants using this low-tech, low-cost approach are now being used worldwide with ablative and non-ablative conditioning and with bone marrow or peripheral blood to treat hematologic malignancies.
I came back to Delhi in June 2014, and I was a part of a protocol of donor lymphocyte infusion with myeloablative conditioning. But as we all aware that all patients are not eligible for myeloablative conditioning, so subsequently we developed CD56 enriched donor cell infusion with non-myeloablative conditioning, and we found the results were extremely good.
Not only have they established centers transplanting hundreds of patients in Calcutta and New Delhi, but their clinical research program has successfully explored new conditioning regimens and use of NK cell and T cell donor lymphocyte infusions to improve survival outcomes.
My daughter Chitralekha is now 5 years old. 1.5 year later, after the success of transplantation, I feel bonded with my two doctors. They saved my baby's life and saved my matched family and have changed my life from darkness to light.
We want to get him transplanted since he's our only son. So full matched transplant was not possible at all. Sir and ma'am, they really helped us to manage for the funds. Usha ma'am also helped us. So with their help, we could manage everything. Now my son is completely fit and fine, and he's ready to go to the school.
I have seen a number of their projects, research projects, materialized during the last 4 years or so, and have seen the success that they have obtained, not only at a national level, but at a global level.
For an Indian patient to get a match from a foreign registry, again, is less than 10% in terms of probability. So what we are left with is either you do a matched family donor transplantation or you end up doing nothing.
It's 3.5 years now. My transplant is done. Though there were matched donors in the registry, but my doctors chose my mother. She was half matched with me, and I received NK cell infusion from my mother.
I was among the first patients to be treated under CTLA-4Ig DLI study.
In February 2016, I had the opportunity to visit their center at the Dharamila Hospital, and I really could appreciate their great work in the setting of haploidentical stem cell transplantation for patients with both malignant and non-malignant hematological diseases. They are now optimizing the use of haploidentical transplantation in their country, and I'm sure they will be able to further develop this exciting project. So Suparno and Sarita receive my strongest and enthusiastic recommendation for their clinical and experimental activity.
We have developed CTLA-4Ig prime donor lymphocyte infusion as a part of novel NK cell immunotherapy. And till date, we have done 35 patients with excellent results. And we had presented DISH and ASH 2017 as well as BMT Tandem 2018.
My mother was proceeded for as the donor of transplant. It was a haploidentical stem cell transplant. In February, I got the treatment over here, and the doctors told me about the complications regarding the treatment, but it was not that difficult time. We proceeded through it with minor complications, but it got over. And around June and all, I got chronic GVHD. But that phase also surpassed, and now I am better, much better.
It's highly privileged to work with our consultants who always guide and support us a lot. Our main goal or effort is to make our patient to feel that they are at their own home, a home away from their home. We have realized that over 4 years that we are dealing with most complex and complicated cases in the country. Irrespective of the outcomes, we realize that we have tried our level best.
We here are a unique mix of clinical and translational research in one roof. The dedication and passion for science translates to excellence in patient care and improved outcomes. With cutting edge in the research and niche area like NK cell immunotherapy and transplantation tolerance, we expect to make many more innovations in near future.
Transplantation is only going to proliferate, supplemented by other procedures or other innovative cellular therapies. Being a cellular therapy in itself, it is only going to expand. We should not have a tunnel view about transplantation, that it is different from cellular therapy.